And see, all this stuff is turning me into this guy I don't want to be, that grouchy old get off my yard guy. Remember that guy? He was like, oh, get off my yard, I hate having kids. It's making me this grouchy guy and I don't want to be it, but I'll give you a great example. The other day, I was in my car and I got stuck behind a school bus. Now, I don't know if you've been stuck behind a school bus before, but once you get there, you're stuck. I've passed kidney stones quicker than you can get around a school bus. But it's the law and I'm stuck, so what the heck? So I'm sitting there and I look up and there's these three 10-year-old boys looking out the back window at me. And I kind of look at them, I smile at them, and the kid in the middle goes like this. And I thought, oh my God, he's slow. So I gave him that, I'm sorry you're slow, wave back, you know. And all of a sudden he goes. And I thought, you little turd. He's saying I'm slow. And his buddies are laughing and all that. I'm about to start yelling. All of a sudden, the adult part of my brain goes, just relax. Ignore this kid. So I pick up my cell phone, act like I'm talking on the phone. And I kind of glance up at the school bus, and the kid in the middle is doing this. And I'm like, and his buddies are laughing, and they're high-fiving and having a great time. And I'm like, you know what? And all of a sudden, I look at this kid, and I realize, oh, this kid's got big ears. So I'm sitting there and I look up at him and I go. And he gets this hangdog look on his face. His buddies are going crazy. I'm like, yeah, you're mine now, punk. I don't even want to get around this bus now. And he's looking all sad and I'm just like, yeah. And I look over to my left and the woman in the car next to me goes, what the hell? And I go, he started it. I think it's just because I'm getting older and I'm getting less patient, you know? It's like I'm in my 50s now, which is a cool age. I love being in my 50s because people got to listen to you now. Yeah, you've been around for a while. Now, the other side of that coin is because you're in your 50s, you still care what people think about you. So you kind of filter what you say. Now, if that's the case, then I cannot wait until I'm 80. Because 80-year-old people don't give a damn what you think. Think about it. How many 80-year-old people with any tact at all do you know? None, because they don't have to. They're 80. Does grandma hold her farts in at the dinner table? No, she doesn't have to. She's earned the right to fart at your dinner table. She'll fart at the pearly gates on the way to meet sweet Jesus. Oh my God, how great is that gonna be? You can say whatever you want. You're 80. You get pulled over by the cops. Do you know why I pulled you over? I don't know why, because you're a jackass? Well, arrest me, I'm 80, I'll be dead by the time the paperwork's done. There's one for the boys back in the precinct. I love being 50. 50 is a very cool age, but it does come with some responsibilities. Like 50-year-old guys can't go out with really young girls anymore. Up till 50, you can. But once you hit 50, you become that creepy old guy. And we've all done it. You see some old guy with some young girl, you don't sit there and go, oh, that is so sweet. This is what everybody in this room says. Money or drugs, that's all I'm saying right there. Money or drugs. But see, I love being a married guy. I knew from the moment I got interested in women, I was destined to be a married guy. I knew that. Because I wasn't a good single guy. You know, I didn't have that banter. You know, that, hey, how you doing? And girls would be like, what the hell was that? What do you got, Tourette's? Yeah, there's a fine line between cool and a neurological disorder, trust me. I remember when I was 14 years old, I saw my very first Playboy magazine. A friend of mine brought some over, which was kind of stupid because all we needed was a Playboy magazine. Actually, all we needed was a page out of a Playboy magazine, but I digress. And I remember I opened up that magazine, I opened up that big page, and I looked at that girl, and I remember thinking, wow, I am not in your ballpark. Because her turn-ons didn't say 14-year-old acne-faced boy. Well, this last year, I caught my son with a Penthouse magazine. I took it away from him. Opened up the big page. And looked at that girl and said, I am still not in her ballpark. I missed that whole ball game. In fact, I'm the guy that left that game early to beat traffic. But that's all right, because I, like I said, I love being a married guy. Unlike my best friend in the world, who just got divorced a couple years ago from a wonderful woman. He'd been married almost as long as I had. And now, he's going out with this little 24-year-old girl. Yeah, and he's trying to tell me how great it is. I called him one night, I said, man, what are you doing? And he goes, dude, it's awesome. And I go, no, it's not. Listen to what you just said. Grown men don't use phrases like, dude, it's awesome. Grown men say things like, I gotta get that mole checked, or are they supposed to hang this low at this age? Found that out the hard way. He goes, you don't get it, man. We have a lot in common. I go, oh, that's right. You graduated in 85. She was born in 85. I go, you got nothing in common. Let's say the two of you go out to dinner and you order an 18-year-old scotch. Thank you. She's only 6 years older than that drink. Yeah, you're ordering scotch. She's ordering jello shots. Rock on. But even when he was married, he couldn't handle it. Even when he was in love with this woman, it was great. He couldn't handle it. One night we were sitting at a bar just having a beer, me and my buddy. And this good-looking woman walked in front of us. Now, I don't mean just good-looking people. I mean good-looking to the point that even other women in the bar went, yeah, I'd do her. That good-looking. And she walks right in front of us, and my friend, without missing a beat, goes, man, ugh, if I wasn't married, I'd be all over that. No, you wouldn't. If you're all over that, pepper spray's involved, all right?